Welcome to this NPTEL MOOC course on basic building blocks of microwave engineering and design principles of RF and microwave filters and amplifiers. Actually, this is a core course. Actually, this relates to the course on microwave engineering in undergraduate curriculum. So, it is expected that those who will attend this course have a prerequisite knowledge of electromagnetic theory, transmission line and network theory. Actually, it is expected that the students know the concepts of Smith chart, scattering parameters and signal flow graphs. If you are not very sure that whether your understanding of these three are clear, then you can refer to another NPTEL MOOC course on basic building blocks of microwave engineering, where basic tools of microwave engineering, where these three concepts have been covered. So, in this course, actually this course has an impact that once you attend this course, you will have knowledge for applying these things to the radar industry, space industry, avionics industry, defense industry, internal security industry, mining, geo-exploration industry, to name a few. Actually, these concepts are heavily used in all these industries, and if you want to have any problems associated with these industries, if you want to solve that, this knowledge will be helpful. Now, in this course, actually, there will be various themes. First theme is theme 1 will cover the model of microwave transmission. Actually, you know, in microwave region or in the high frequency region, the waves propagates in modes, various modes. The power, microwave power, gets propagated by various modes. So, we will first discuss the concept of those modes, and then we will see various modes like transverse electric modes, transverse magnetic modes, transverse electromagnetic modes, etcetera. Then when microwave energy propagates, there are losses. So, we will see how in the microwave region those losses comes and how to model that. Then we will see a elegant concept of impedance. Actually, this impedance concept makes the whole system characterization possible. So, how that impedance concept comes, and there are various impedances associated with this transmission. There are intrinsic impedance of the medium, there are characteristic impedance of the transmission line section, there are wave impedance of the electromagnetic wave. So, all those will be covered, and it is part of the training of an electronics engineer, high frequency electronics engineer, to understand that in which case which impedance is relevant, so that he can carry out his analysis and design based on that impedance concept. Then we will see various transmission lines. You all know that at high frequency, the lines are distributed in nature. So, we will see various lines like the cylindrical lines, double cylindrical lines, that is coaxial lines, then single cylindrical lines or just a metal cylinder or a metal pipe like waveguides, then various planar lines like microstrip lines, strip lines, all those will be then covered. So, this is the theme, that is the model of microwave transmission. In the second theme, we will see the passive, various passive circuit components used in microwave region. We will see what are the circuit components that couples power from one part to another part, then power combiners, power dividers, then how to, if you have two powers, how to make sum, how to make difference by a single device, that is called magic T, then how to reduce the power, those are power attenuators, then how to resonate power, that is power resonators. So, all that will be covered in theme 2. In theme 3, we will see the active devices, those are used in microwave region. We will start with various diodes which can give microwave signals. So, we will start with GaN diode, we will see impact diode, we will see Schottky barrier diode, we will see PIN diode. So, these things first we will see. Then we will see the 3 terminal devices, transistors, so microwave and RF transistors, that what are they, that we will discuss. Then again we will see some of the vacuum tubes, those are still relevant and will be relevant because of their high power handling capability, particularly in radar etcetera industry. So, we will see magnetron, how it functions, klystron, then how that high power amplifier, TWT amplifier, traveling wave tube amplifier, that we will see. And then we will move to the next themes, that microwave filter design. Now, actually this microwave filter design, nowadays it is the microwave filter design is introduced in undergraduate curriculum, but not completed. But in when we see the high frequency things, these filters are a basic building block of any electronic circuitry. So, if you remember that in your network theory in undergraduate curriculum, maybe in second, third year, that you have been taught various two port impedances, and from that a concept of image impedance probably was introduced. But from that image impedance, how the concept of characteristic impedance comes, I do not know whether that was covered, but we will see that every two port network that can have a characteristic impedance, and from that characteristic impedance actually how you can a filter gets designed. So, this is called image impedance based filter design method. Now, this was very popular when the in telephonic industry in early part of 20th century, that time this image impedance based filter design was very popular. So, that actually clears many of the electronic network theory concepts. So, that we will first see, but there is a better method later it got popularity, that is called insertion loss based filter design, that we will discuss next. So, by that we will actually with that thing we will generalize the design, and any type of given filter response can be designed. So, first we will start with a prototype low pass filter, and then we will see that how you can easily change that design or scale that design or transform that design to other types of filters like high pass filter, band pass filter, band stop filter, band reject filter, all those things we will see. And then we will see at high frequency how those filters are implemented, because in high frequency you cannot have lumped implementation. So, you need distributed elements at microwave frequency. So, how these filters are implemented, that we will see. Then we will see a practical high frequency filter design, and by that we will try to exemplify all the things that are needed to be known by an electronic engineer to design a filter. We hope that after going through this theme, you will be able to design any given microwave filter. Then we will move to the next theme, that is amplifier design. Now, in your undergraduate curriculum in low frequency circuit design classes, lot of transistor based amplifiers were designed, but these were all low frequency designs, may be valid up to few megahertz sort of thing, but if you go to 300, 400 megahertz things, that becomes an RF amplifier design. So, in that frequency the main problem is the, we will see, which you have not seen earlier, that in this course we will see that what is the concept of stability and what do we mean by stability of active devices like transistors, etcetera. So, how to quantify that stability, and then how based on that we can design RF amplifiers which are unconditionally stable, that means for any given choice of source and load impedances, that amplifiers how to make unconditionally stable. Also sometimes unconditionally stable amplifier is an overkill or a very conservative thing. So, how to make it conditionally stable, so that if I know that I will not have all sorts of load and sources, I will have a specific set of load and sources, then we can be satisfied with a conditionally stable amplifier design. Also, if certain applications required a specific gain from an amplifier, how to most optimally design that, that we will see next. Then we will move on to the designs of power amplifiers. In power amplifiers, you know, it is the in a transmitting chain, it is the last block where it gives the signal sufficient power to travel the wireless path. Now, there when you are doing that, when you are giving that power, the concept of linearity comes, because we know if we do not have linearity, then there are several problems comes for the signal. So, how to characterize linearity or how to characterize non-linearity. Actually, non-linearity gets characterized by some compression points, then dynamic range, spurious speed dynamic range, then third order intercept points, all those concepts of non-linearity will come, and then also how to measure those non-linearities, that we will discuss, and finally, we will characterize a power amplifier in terms of these figure of merits of non-linearity. And then we will see another thing, you know, in any receiving chain after antenna, the first amplifier that is put is a low noise amplifier. Now, there we will discuss that how to design a low noise amplifier. For that, we will design what are the noise parameters of active devices, then what is meant by constant noise figure circle, so that you can, with the help of that, you can find out what are the amplifiers parameters from that. Then you know that Smith chart, you are familiar with Smith chart, but all the loads etcetera there are for a from a passive device, but the moment you are putting transistor amplifier, now that time it is an active device. So, how to extend the Smith chart for these active devices, that we will discuss. And then if for a LNA design a specified noise figure is given, how to design that with the help of this Smith chart, that we will see. Then we will see how to design broadband amplifiers, because nowadays with the signal getting broadbanded, the transmission lines getting broadbanded, there is a need to have broadband amplifier design. Then what is a balanced amplifier, all those will see, and we expect that after you go through this theme, that you will be able to design any RF based amplifier. And actually, you know that amplifiers and filters, they are part of every microwave circuitry. So, whether you are designing a computer, whether you are designing any electronic system, there always it is necessary that you should have amplifiers, filters, etcetera. So, you should be very, very well conversant with designing of that, because this is the bread and butter of any electronics engineer. So, we hope that after going through this course, you will be able to have that confidence in you. We'll be giving you with the lectures, there will be every week there will be assignments based on the lectures. Also, there will be tutorials where we will show that how to solve those design problems, and based on that there will be, you know, in MOOC there are tests. In the test you will be evaluated based on the test and your performance in assignment. In all the assignments we will, after you submit your assignments, we will check it and we will return you the your scores, as well as we will give you the model solutions for that. And also there will be forums where course forums where you will be able to ask anything which is you are finding difficult to understand, or which in the lecture whatever is not clear, that by a discussion will be you can understand in the forum. We will be always there to help you. TAs will be there who will be helping you. So, I think this course, if you take, it will give you a good foundation on microwave engineering. We will be following mainly two books for this course. One is the Pojar's very good book on microwave engineering. We will give all these details in the course, and also there is a book by Gonzalez on transistor amplifier design. These are classical books. So, based on these books, I think we will be doing this, and after doing this course, I think you will enjoy learning and you will have confidence that you will be able to design amplifiers, filters, etcetera, for any frequency up to gigahertz frequency will be comfortable. I hope you will all enroll for this course and you will be active in the forums. We will be always there to clarify your concepts, whatever we know. So, let us for this course have a combined journey when we will be trying to share whatever we know, and you will try to assimilate what we want to share. Thank you.